Christoph in this Divinity Original Sin 2. Sorry. Sorry about that. So as you can tell, everybody is still dead, but I was able to, let me just go past this again. Poison, who cares? I was able to finish off this little area with all these, little things. And let's see if I can refine where I was. I'd go a little further ahead to see something. Ah, here we go.
On the ledge before you, a lone lizard woman overlooks the marshes. Her stare is as sharp as the bolt eyeing you from atop her crossbow.
Stand back and keep your hands off your weapons. Convince me you're no magister, or draw one last deep breath.
She notices your collar, and you can see the tension ease out of her martial pose.
No. No, I suppose you don't look like a magister. Those dogs don't leash their own. Except for Alexander himself, as it happens.
I apologize for this steel-tipped welcome, but lives are at stake. Hold on, I'll let you up.
With one graceful motion, the lizard throws down a tangled mess of vines for you to climb.
Come, ascend to the sanctuary of Amardia. You'll find you're not the only guest here, but the Great Mother provides for all.
Okay.
The seven watch o'er us. You're safe in bed. So close your sweet eyes and rest.
Amidst the placid little pond, the face of a goddess lies half submerged in the water. Rivulets stream from her deep-set eyes like endless cascades of sunlit tears. You feel peaceful in her presence, soothed somehow by an intangible comfort. As you gaze upon her loving face, you find yourself drawn into a trance-like state. A voice seems to reach you from within your mind and from the furthest reaches of the stars. Its whispers caress you like a breeze. The voice grows stronger, like a breeze picking up. What were whispers become words.
My children, my children. Gone are my children. Dead are they in the cradle I have wrought.
A feeling of indescribable sadness assails you. It feels like your heart merges with the spirits, torn together by a coil of thorns.
My child, weep with me for the mother who has lost. Weep with me. And bathe in the tears of Amardia.
If you had tears, they'd mingle with those of the goddess down in the tranquil crystalline pond.
You, my child, I bless you.
You feel yourself shine with an inner light, rejuvenated and pure, as if born anew. The goddess's tears still stream freely, and all is quiet by the tranquil pond.
There we go. That's where I wanted to go.
I only stock the best precious wares, are they not?
Yes, he has more. No, I need to do this first. Ah, shit, I did the wrong thing. All in, take a little out. That might be too much. Yeah, that's too much. That's a name. But finally, I can res all these people. Because I don't know how else to do it. Besides with these scrolls. No, I don't want to loot. Okay, that went well. Oh, they have level ups, don't they? Let me just reconnect. Button. Towards control. Okay. Okay. Any moment. Need to refine that hideout. Yeah, I think I went the wrong way. That's not it either. Well, that's new. Yeah, I think that's actually guarded, I just can't see the things guarding it. I know how that only get back. Quick way, an easy way. Teleport back.
The stone form exudes warmth and grace, welcoming you. A grim-faced man sifts through a pile of badly damaged weapons, salvaging the repairable, ditching the broken. He picks up a rapier, the blade nicked and splintered, the hilt twisted. He holds the damaged blade up to the light.
This was Halorn's blade. It was his first, it was also his last. He didn't intend to die here, but die here he did. He was an ordinary soul with an extraordinary heart, Halorn, and he died for what he believed.
Thank you. The point breaks away, leaving a jagged edge. The sword is shorter now, but it'll do more damage.
Who are you?
He realizes, to his surprise, that he holds the weapon in his hand, ready for battle. He smiles to himself, tucks the weapon away, and gets back to work.
Okay.
You're certain it was Verdus? Hello, stranger.
The disheveled pair eye you with hope, though their hope is tinged with mistrust. The lizard notices your collar.
You've come from Fort Joy. Can I ask if... did you happen to meet a man named Gareth on your way here through the swamp?
He'll be back, Samadel. I know he will. He has to.
He has to, indeed. We need our leader. And if he doesn't return with help soon, we have to hope. You're kind to offer. But you'd best talk to Gareth's squire, Exeter. He'll know where your talents can be most used. Now, Han, let's take a look at your nasty leg injury.
Catch you later, stranger. It's good you're here.
Okay.
The lizard holds a crimson-soaked rag against his side. He looks up as you approach, his expression oddly serene.
Magisters, they found our camp near the old harbor and unleashed hell upon us. I'm lucky in a way. I was wounded by an arrow. It wasn't just sword and spear the Magisters used on us. No, they had these weapons. Living beings, depleted of source and crucified, pathetic to look at until... the power that he unleashed. There was nothing we could do. Only run. Shriekers, they're called. I can still hear that sound you uttered. Makes my scales crawl.
Sir Gareth is looking for a way to defeat them. Let us hope he finds.
Lord, turn your head if you can hear me.
A dwarf stands by a young woman. He seems intensely focused on her, whispering and singing softly in her ear. She's staring blankly into space.
Blood and bone. Fire and smoke. Death and worse.
Hush now, Leia. They'll not hurt you again. You're safe now. Once Gareth gets back, we're going home. You'll see. He'll be fine.
The woman rubs her neck, raking her nails across her skin as she whimpers. The dwarf starts at the sound of your voice, gripping the woman's arm for a moment before he relaxes.
New faces. Hope you aren't bushwhacked by the Magisters too. As for her neck, she's remembering the damnable source collar she once wore. Same style as yours. Lucky for us, she had the skills to remove them. There's many a sorcerer that's been free thanks to her.
The woman's eyes dart to your own neck.
Choke us. They strangle us. Steal our voices.
She averts her eyes, staring at the ground.
They'll have more luck getting Dallas to unlock them. The poor girl's not in her best mind without Gareth. Sorry, friend. I'm as powerless here as you are. I've not got her power. Best I can do is hum a tune and try to keep her still. Gareth's the only one that brings her out of herself. Without him, she's...
Duggan lays his hand on her shoulder, squeezing it tight as tears roll down her cheeks.
We were part of the caravan headed to Fort Joy. Shiny collars and all. Gareth and the Seekers ambushed the caravan and freed us. Saved every one of us from that hell. But now he's off searching for weapons to take down them Shriekers. And all we can do is sit here, thinking about the Godwoken we didn't save.
From fragments to whole. From their past to our future. From their hope to ours.
She ain't detailed, but she ain't wrong. The Godwoken are our hope that a new divine can be born. Someone to replace Lucian and push back the Voidwoken. Someone to restore order and protect the source. I'd speak to Exeter if you want to know more. There's ways, but I ain't privy to them. One thing I do know, mate, the Voidwalken have their number. They react to Godwalken like no one else.
Barking dogs in wolves' clothing. Teeth in the sea. Teeth in the swamp. Teeth in the air.
Aye, there's enough of them about. But don't you worry, mate. Gareth will be back soon. Then he'll be home in 2 shakes of a lamb's tail. We were part of the caravan headed to Fort Joy. Shiny collars and all. But now he's off searching for weapons.
The dwarf starts to sing. A young man in oversized armor paces around a table covered with a spread of maps, his face a tight scowl of frustration.
Every approach blocked. Damn it! What good are battle tactics against those things anyway?
He glances up. In quick succession, he becomes aware of both your presence and the fact that you're not a familiar figure.
Who the blazes are you? A sorcerer? Indeed. I should have realized. A seeker can always recognize a sorcerer when they see one. Though, of course, your collar gives you away. You meant Verdus. Then he's as good as dead. We're the seekers he spoke of. We were supposed to free him. Instead, we failed him. You, a Godwoken? Surely not. Though if Verdus said so, you could be important. But there's no way to be certain until we've left this blasted island behind us.
The young man anxiously fidgets with his curved bow. You've found a matter close to his heart, evidently.
That's easier said than done, I'm afraid. Much easier said. Yet the Magisters have us cornered. They have these weapons called Shriekers. If we try to go against them unprepared, we're dead. We've lost many already. There's weapons, ancient devices that can counter those things. Our leader, Sir Gareth, set out to find them so we could break the Magister blockade and escape this island. But he hasn't returned. If Sir Gareth doesn't come back with those weapons in tow, then this island will be our grave. You'll help us.
His shoulders visibly relax, the weighty armor upon them settling with a clink.
Thank you. Allies are in short supply in this place. If you help us, I promise we'll get you as far away from this place as possible.
That's nice, but time for a rest. Oh wait, not that character. Everyone else but that character.
No, we don't have the time. Gareth,
I want to. Oh, he's resting. I have a crossbow for him. That's just a wand. Do I have any other ones? Okay. Actually, they're the way I originally came when I was just checking this place out first, not recording. There's a way up here that I can knock down. Nope. But that's the reason I came alone, the poison. I don't think there's anything else there anyways. Fire was easy enough to get past, but the poison was the problem. Okay. Does it tell me where the hell he is? Oh no, that's just the first reason to take the collar off.
Do you hear the call, unliving? The king will soon.
Interesting.
I am death and light.
What is she doing way back there? Yeah, I did get a turn, didn't I? Forgot that I summoned one of those.
Child, let me embrace you. let me heal you.
He wants me to find you.
Why doesn't it come to me? Interesting.
Hey, hey you. Let me see what you've got under there. Go on, go on. Show me your... Pekka! Wait, do you even have a Pekka? Why are you still speaking? If there was a cave to explore, do you think I'd tell you? How awkward. See, the thing is, just stop. No one cares what you have to say. You're embarrassing yourself. Leave.
Weird.
Pathetic. Ha! You want to hit me, don't you? Go on then. Give it your best shot. Ah, clever.
I tell you to leave. Wasn't I clear that you're not welcome here?
You can't teach a fool anything.
Not what I was expecting.
Thank you.
Of course, that was a trap.
An illusion. This fellow must be quite proud of himself.
And now we're down to Claire. Or teammate, or friend, or whatever the hell you want to call him. Is he still back here? Huh.
Pathetic boy. This isn't some game. In what world does treasure simply appear from on
high? I thought it was a game. Apparently I was mistaken. I want to talk.
It's a riddle, isn't it? A conundrum. What's it? You'll have to solve. I thought you looked clueless, right? Thing is, it's about the letters, isn't it? One for each thing. Easy. Well, nice to meet you too. Rude. Thing.
Come to find. You come to search. But you won't find the way. A pity. Brachus has willed it. Chomp Noi must abide. You have met the unfortunate guardian of this vault. Judge him with a forgiving heart. Fate has been unkind to him. Do you wish to move forward? Listen closely and make your attempt. Brachus is a bloody, rotten, thieving, very, very awful fellow. Some even call him a cur. A cur is... Either you're very good at guessing, or the slightest bit clever. Let's find out for certain. Listen closely, and make your attempt. Source is a scourge, a devil, a misery, a blight, a hex, a curse. And yet, the cure is... Fool, you are unequal to the task at hand. You will not move forward out of my...
Slowly, gravely, he's shaken.
Look at them. Leave the room alone. Oh my. Is that the time? Make one more attempt and then I think I have to get off.
You come to find. You come to search. But you won't find the way. A pity. Bracchus has willed it. Judge him with a forgiving heart. Do you wish to move forward? Listen close. Bracchus is a bloody, rotten, thieving. Either you're very good at. Listen closely. Source is a scourge, a devil, a misery, a blight, a hex, a curse. And yet, the cure fool, you are an equal.
Okay, well, thank you all for watching. Please like, share, subscribe, comment, and I'll see you all in the next video. Bye.